Leia here from leiaforsci.com, and in this video, we're going to look at the aromatic side-chain oxidation reaction. When you react a substituted benzene like toluene with a strong oxidizing agent like chromic acid, sodium dichromate, or potassium permanganate, the product is a carboxylic acid. You've already seen these oxidizing agents in the past. For example, the oxidative cleavage of an alkene using potassium permanganate to give us two carboxylic acids, or the oxidation of an alcohol into a carboxylic acid. But what if I expose an alkane to a strong oxidizing agent? My product? No reaction. What if I expose benzene to a strong oxidizing agent? Once again, no reaction. But if I put them together and have an alkyl group on benzene, the same reagents that individually gave us no reaction gives us a fully oxidized side chain, oxidizing the methyl group all the way to a carboxylic acid. Notice that I had to add H+ in the second step because potassium permanganate operates under basic conditions, giving us the carboxylate anion. Adding H+ in the next step will protonate the oxygen to give us the neutral carboxylic acid. So what are we looking at in this reaction? Both alkene and benzene are very stable and not susceptible to oxidation, but when we put them together, the benzylic carbon, which is the carbon directly attached to the benzene, becomes more reactive and more susceptible to oxidation. The bad news is that the mechanism is very complicated and not fully understood. It involves a radical intermediate, grabbing the proton, some serious changes happening to the manganese. But the good news is, you don't have to know this mechanism in undergrad orgo. So what do you have to know? The takeaways from the mechanism. And the biggest takeaway is that the mechanism uses a benzylic hydrogen atom to initiate the oxidation. That means without that hydrogen, no oxidation. And so without worrying about learning the mechanism, just imagine that the oxidizing reagent, which could be some version of chromic acid or potassium permanganate, grabs onto the benzylic hydrogen as a means of latching onto the molecule, cuts everything else off, and then oxidizes it all the way to a carboxylic acid. And it's not just methyl, it's any alkyl side chain that has a benzylic hydrogen. If you're asked to oxidize a ring with an ethyl group, you identify the first carbon, verify that it has a hydrogen, cut everything else off, and the product is a carboxylic acid, specifically benzoic acid, meaning it's not the last carbon that gets oxidized, it's the benzylic carbon where everything else is cut off. If you're asked to oxidize benzene with an isopropyl group, that's a benzylic carbon with two substituents, it doesn't matter. So long as there is one hydrogen atom, the oxidizing agent can grab onto that, cut off everything else, and give you a benzoic acid. What if you were given a benzene ring with a tert-butyl group and asked to oxidize it? Well, we have a benzylic carbon, but we don't have any benzylic hydrogen. Carbon is bound to the benzene ring, and then 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. That means it already has 4 bonds, there's no 5th bond to hydrogen, and that means there's no reaction. But it doesn't stop here. If you're asked to react a benzene that has 2 different substituents with KMnO4, so long as each substituent has a benzylic carbon with at least 1 benzylic hydrogen present, the same thing will happen. Each carbon will get oxidized to a carboxylic acid, and the remaining carbons that were attached are broken off. Each carbon gets oxidized to a carboxylic acid, regardless of what else was attached, so long as we had the benzylic hydrogen. So what if I give you a molecule that looks like this? We have a fused ring system where one ring is aromatic and one is not, and we're told to react it with KMnO4. We treat this the same way. Don't let that second ring scare you. If you see KMnO4 with something attached to a benzene ring, ask yourself, what does KMnO4 do? It's a strong oxidizing agent. What is it looking for? A hydrogen on a benzylic carbon. If we look at the benzene ring, we have 2 benzylic carbons. Each has at least 1 hydrogen atom, and that means when we react, everything else gets cut off, giving me a final product with 2 carboxylic acids coming out of the benzene ring and the second ring broken in the process of this oxidation. You can find this entire video series along with my redox practice quiz and cheat sheet by visiting my website, layerforsci.com/redox.